Good morning, my dear students. So my name is B. Nagaraj Naik. Recently, I appointed as a NEET faculty in Royal Palace PU College. So I have 10 years of experience in NEET. I previously worked in Tirupati Sri Chaitanya NEET Academics. So now, in this session, I am going to start the second PUC, first chapter based on NEET, what kind of the questions they will ask. So that chapter we called it as the reproduction in organisms. So reproduction is a very important process. Why it is important process in the sense? Because of maintenance of generations and generations. That we called it as to continuation of the generations of species to next generations. For that purpose, only the process which helps, we called it as the reproduction. So this reproduction is a biological process. It is a biological process. To involve, it helps for production of new young ones. Or offsprings from parents, parent organisms. The production of new young ones or offsprings from parent organisms is called as the reproduction process. So this reproduction process, we called it as a biological process. Why? Because living organisms can performing the process, we called it as a reproduction. That's why reproduction is a biological process. While you have to observe the organisms which are present in our surroundings, like many of the greenery plants we are observing. In that plants also, like algae, bryophytes, pteridophytes, and gymnosperms, angiosperms, like all different varieties of plant species we are observing. Likewise, in the animals, if you have to take the animals, like from Porifera, Coelenterata, Ctenophora, and Oschelmints, Platyhelminths, Annelids, Molluscans, Echinodermates, Chordates, in that chordates also tunicates and the eels, mammals and reptiles, birds, like different types of the animal species also we can observe. Apart from these, like bacterial cells, those we can consider as unicellular organisms also. Likewise, in the protist organisms, like monerians and the protist organisms also we can observe. So those kind of the organisms also, they shows their continuity of generations. So for that, every organism has the continuity. Due to that continuity only, today we are finding the Homo sapiens on the Earth region. From that ancestors, from the 5 billion years ago itself, the human life has started on Earth region. But now also we are finding the modern persons. Why these modern persons today on Earth region in the sense? Because of the continuation is occurring by the help of a mechanism called as reproduction. Now, if every organism has a specific lifespan period, so this lifespan period, how to measure a lifespan? So the lifespan it represents, it is the period between birth to the natural death. It is a period between birth to natural death. Of an organism, the period between birth to the natural death, that death should be occur by naturally, not by accidents, not by the suicides, or not by any diseases affected. So such kind of the deaths we can't consider for their lifespan period. If you have to observe the animals or the plants which has a specific lifespan period. So this lifespan period should be differ from species to species. So some species of the plants can survive some few minutes or few days only. If some other species of the plants can survive several hundreds to thousands years of time period also. Like in animals also, some of the birds or some flies can survive one day, or some animals can survive 70 years, 100 years, 140 years, or even 150 years also, some organisms are surviving. So let us take and to observe what are the organisms of the lifespan, how they are measurable, or how those organisms approximate lifespan can be seen. So those organisms can be taken as example. Many of the examples we can give for this lifespan. So if you have to observe, in case of the mayfly, that's a very a small fly, it can survive only one day. Their lifespan period is only one day it can survive. So 24 hours, within that 24 hours only, it will be growth, maturity, juvenility, and senescence, death, all it will be occur within one day. It will complete. At the 24th hour, it will be goes to die. And if you have to observe in case of the butterfly, so these butterfly can survive from 1 to 2 weeks. And fruit fly, if these fruit fly organisms you may observe, can survive up to 30 days. It means 1 month approximately. Like in the other organisms, you may observe the crow can survive 15 years and the cow 25 years. And like cat can survive 35 to 40 years. And the rat can survive 4 years. Like in the horse can survive 40 years. And the parrot 140 years it can survive. And in case of the crocodile, can survive 60 years. And in case of elephant, can survive 70 years. Like the animals, those we called it as like mayfly, butterflies, fruit flies, crow, cow, cat, rat, horse, parrot, crocodile, elephant. Like these different organisms are surviving with different lifespan periods. So this lifespan period can be observed even in the plants. Like you may observe a very familiar plant like rice. So rice plants can survive nearly 4 months. And in case of the wheat crop, the wheat plants can survive 5 months. And in case of the rose bush, that rose plants can survive up to 10 years. And in case of the banana, can survive up to 25 years. And in a banyan tree, can survive from 200 to 300 years. And in case of the peepal tree, can survive from 2000 to 3000 years. It can survive. Like from that very short period to till some thousands of the years also, the plants can able to survive. It means compared to the animals, the plants are showing a much more lifespan period. Why they are showing the much more lifespan period in the sense? Because of continuous growth is occur at the tip portion of plant bodies, like stem tip and the root tip and the branches tip region, the growth is occur continuously. Why this growth is occur continuously at the tip portion only? Why not in the other portions in the sense? Because of in the tip portion, the presence of meristematic tissues. The meristematic tissues can cooperate continuous divisions. The cell divisions are occurred continuously. That's why they are showing the undifferentiated growth continuously. So you may observe a very oldest plant has found in the southwest California region. That name of the plant, we called it as the Lura. Tridentata. So it is a very oldest plant found in the southwest California. It is nearly 11,300 years old it is. The very oldest plant found in the southwest California, that name of the plant we called it as the Lura tridentata. It's a very oldest plant. And if you have to observe, what is the need of these reproduction? What is the importance of this reproduction? So how a reproduction can help to the organisms? What is the basic importance of the reproduction in the sense that we called it as the continuation of the generations from, or we called it as continuity of the races from one generation to another generation, from another generation to another generation. This chain-like phenomenon is depends with the help of a reproduction mechanisms. Well, you have to observe, every organism has their lifespan period. In these lifespan period, it including four different phases. Every individual, it includes four different phases during their lifespan. So those phases we called it as, one it is a growth phase. And the other one we called it as a maturity period. The maturity phase. And the third one we called it as a senescent phase. And the fourth one we called it as a death phase. What is a growth phase or juvenility? The growth phase also we called it as the juvenility. The growth phase also we call it as the juvenility. So juvenility, it represents the from that birth to from a birth to maturity. So birth to reach the maturity, this period we called it as growth period. During this growth period, the growth is present a very huge manner in all the organisms, whether it may be plant bodies or animal bodies. How we can determine the growth in the plant bodies? If you have to observe a plant, a seed we have taken, that we kept in the soil. After few days, it will start to germinate. So from that germinate onwards, till it has to produce the flowers, in case of angiosperms, it will start to produce us the flowers. This period, we called it as a juvenile period or growth phase. And when you have to observe in the maturity period, during maturity period, gametes are producing period. Gametes production. The gametes production. Gametes production in the sense, like the male parts of the flowering plants, like anther we are calling, it will start to produce us the male gametes, like pollen grains. Like the female part of the plant, we called it as the ovary, it will produce us the egg cells. Like in human beings and the other organisms also, the male gametes are produced by the male individuals. The female gametes are produced by the female individuals. That gametes are the haploid cells which will help for the reproduction. Like the maturity period, during this maturity time, also we called it as a reproductive years. This reproductive years, they are very comfortable start to produce us the gametes. Then this maturity can leads to reach the senescence. The senescent phase we called it as the old age period. During this old age, the metabolic activities rate will be decreased. And the reproductive capacity and the digestion capacity, respiratory capacity, circulatory capacity, like all these functions of metabolic should be reduced in the old organisms. That we called it as low rate, or the maturity can leads to the senescence. Slow down the metabolic activities is the functions. Slow down the metabolic functions that we can observe during the time of senescent period. Senescent period, how can we observe? The best example, human beings. The females who are reached at the age of 45 to 50 years, then the menstrual cycles will be stops. It means the seizures of menstrual cycles, the mechanism we called it as menopause. That menopause period can be seen in the female organisms at the age of 45 to 50 years. After that reaching of 50 years, these organisms can't able to reproduce. They are not producing the gametes of female egg cell. At the same time, they are not capable to produce their young ones. So that we called it as a seizures period, or the seizing period, or end period of the human beings is a senescent period. Like in the death phase, that it represents the senescence, it leads so the senescence period can we called it as a maturity period. After maturity, it leads to the senescence. During the senescence, what will happen in the sense of slowdown of all the metabolic functions. So now the senescence period finally leads to the death of an individual, whether it may be the plant bodies or the animal bodies, finally the death it will be occur. So thank you. We will continue these concepts in the next class, like sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction, different methods of the asexual reproductions, that we will discuss in next class.